My fellow countrymen, it was in America that the art of flying of heavier than air machines was first developed. As the experiments became successful, the airplane was devoted to practical purposes. It has been adapted to commerce in the transportation of passengers and mail, and used for national defense by our land and sea forces. Beginning with a limited flying radius, its length has been gradually extended. We have made many flying records. Our army flyers have circumnavigated the globe. One of our Navy men started from California and flew far enough to have reached Hawaii, but being off his course, landed in the water. Another officer of the Navy has flown to the North Pole. Our own country has been traversed from shore to shore in a single flight. It had been apparent for some time that the next great feat of the air would be a continuous flight from the mainland of America to the mainland of Europe. Two courageous Frenchmen made the reverse attempt and passed to a fate that is as yet unknown. Others were speeding their preparations to make the trial, but it remained for an unknown youth to tempt the elements and win. It is the same story of valor and victory by a son of the people. After months of most careful preparation, supported by a valiant character, driven by an unconquerable will, and inspired by the imagination and the spirit of his Viking ancestors, this reserve officer set wing across the danger stretches of the North Atlantic. He was alone. His destination was Paris. 33 hours and 30 minutes later, in the evening of the second day, he landed at his destination on the French flying field of Le Bourget. He had traveled 3,600 miles and established a new and remarkable record. The execution of his project was a perfect exhibition of art. This country will always remember the way in which he was received by the people of France, by their president, and by their government. And now, my fellow citizens, this young man has returned. He is here. He has brought his unsullied fame home. It is our great privilege to welcome back to his native land, on behalf of his own people, who have a deep affection for him and have been thrilled by his splendid achievement, a colonel of the United States Officers Reserve Corps, an illustrious citizen of our republic, a conqueror of the air and strengthener of the ties which bind us to our sister nations across the sea. And as President of the United States, I bestow the Distinguished Flying Cross as a symbol of appreciation for what he is and what he has done upon Colonel Charles A. Lindbergh. On the evening of the 21st of May last, I arrived at Le Bourget, Paris. During the week I spent in France, the day in Belgium, and the short period in London and England, the people of France and the people of Europe requested that I bring back to the people of America one message from the people of France and the people of Europe. At every gathering, at every meeting I attended, were the same words. You have seen the affection of the people of France for the people of America demonstrated to you. When you return to your country, take back with you this message from France and Europe to the United States of America. I thank you.
Start the band.